Hey there, and welcome to episode number 108 of the Busy Kids Love Music podcast, a podcast for music-loving families. I'm your host, Carly Seifert, the creator of Busy Kids Do Piano, and I'm excited to have you here with me today for a brand new episode. This month on the podcast, we've been learning about Italian composer Giuseppe Verdi. And I'll link to the show notes to the episode from last time where we learned about his life and musical contributions. Today, we're going to dive deeply into the enchanting world of one of Verdi's famous operas, Aida. Imagine a land of pyramids, pharaohs, and mysteries, ancient Egypt. Aida is set in this magical place, and it's a story filled with love, betrayal, and grandeur. Picture yourself in the bustling city of Cairo, where Aida first premiered in 1871. The opera tells the story of a beautiful Ethiopian princess named Aida, who is captured and taken to Egypt as a slave. She falls in love with Radamès, an Egyptian warrior, but there's a big problem. They're from different countries, and their love is forbidden. Now, here's the twist. Radamès is chosen to lead the Egyptian army against Aida's homeland, Ethiopia. So our two lovers find themselves torn between their love for each other and their loyalty to their respective countries. The drama intensifies as Amneris, the Egyptian princess, also falls in love with Radamès. Talk about a love triangle. And amidst all this romance, there's also the grandeur of Egypt's pharaohs and these epic battles on stage. One of the most famous moments in Aida is the triumphal march. It's like a dazzling parade with elephants and chariots and hundreds of people celebrating a victorious return from war. It's a breathtaking spectacle that will leave you in awe, and I will be sure to place a video clip of that scene into the playlist that you'll find in this episode's show notes at busykidsdopiano.com/podcast/108 so that you can actually see the scene. Another famous piece from the opera is called Celeste Aida. This song is an example of an aria. An aria is like a musical star in an opera. It's a special song that's packed with feelings and tells us what a character in the opera is thinking or feeling. Aria songs are like windows into the hearts of the characters, where they can share their dreams, their hopes, even their worries with the audience. In this aria, the brave warrior, Radamès, sings about his love for the beautiful Aida and how she shines like a star in his heart. The opera Aida was commissioned to celebrate the opening of the Suez Canal, a significant engineering achievement. The Suez Canal is a waterway in Egypt that connects the Mediterranean Sea to the Red Sea. The canal was a joint project between Egypt and France, and the premiere of Aida was planned as a lavish event to mark this occasion. And the leader of Egypt asked Verdi to compose a work that could be performed on an epic scale. The premiere of this opera, Aida, was grand and unforgettable in the world of music. It took place on December 24, 1871, at the Khedivial Opera House in Cairo, Egypt. Imagine a theater filled with lavish Egyptian-inspired costumes, captivating stage sets, and a story set in ancient Egypt. The audience was mesmerized by the opera's majestic music and the thrilling tale of love and loyalty. The premiere was a dazzling success, and Aida has since been performed all over the world. It even inspired a Broadway musical by the same name with music and lyrics by Elton John and Tim Rice, which debuted in the year 2000. Thank you for joining me on this journey through ancient Egypt with Aida. You can explore more about this opera by visiting the link to the curated playlist that I put together for you. I mentioned it earlier. And that link is at busykidsdopiano.com/podcast/108. Until next time, keep listening and discovering the world of music, and I look forward to connecting with you again in 2 weeks. Bye for now.